The New York City Transit has been a part of New Yorkers since 1904 and is one of the oldest public transit systems in the world. Today, the Metropolitan Transit Authority is perceived by New Yorkers as an obsolete system in comparison to the major cities around the world. With outdated infrastructure and faulty technology, the MTA is also failing in providing support to those who have a disability. Trains and buses should have proper access to everybody, especially to those who have special needs.
They have gotten better. They're not, every station isn't equipped for the disabled, but I think that they have gotten a lot better.
I've been using the subway system in New York City since the 1990s. And I'm telling you, back then you'd get stuck on elevators, people wouldn't help you, nobody knew what to do. You'd go in the elevators and the smell was so bad, you like wanted to run kicking and screaming out of the place. It's gotten so much better, but still, there are a lot of challenges. There are not enough elevators. There's a huge competition for elevators with people with strollers and people who can walk. And you know, it's sometimes really hard if you're in a wheelchair to get priority to get into the subway. And you really have to know where you're going, because if something goes wrong, you're stuck. I've been stuck sometimes where I got on a line and all the other elevators on the line were broken. So I had to go all the way to Pelham on the 4 line to turn and cross the track and come home. It took me the whole day.
Over the years, the MTA has taken to a new level. They added new buses, fully accessible, and also improved some stations with elevators and ramps for people with disabilities. Alex LeGoudin, the accessibility chief, specially hired for this purpose, has a priority task to improve the MTA system.
What kind of ideas or suggestions did you consider after talking with the disabled community?
Well, we talk to the disabled community almost every day. We do ride-alongs weekly and get their feedback. And the truth is, before any feature goes out, whether it's a new sign, whether it's a new bus feature, we make sure we get the community involved for them to come and see it, preview it, give us their feedback so we get it right. I think that in terms of what the community demands or asks for the most, it varies on the community, right? Those who are blind or low vision are always asking us to make sure everything is audible, to make sure that our signage is right, to make sure we have wayfinding solutions. And similarly, for those with intellectual or developmental disabilities, they want to know how can we best help them navigate our system. We have a huge system.
This is a major challenge, considering roughly 80% of the city's subway stations are inaccessible to hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers who use wheelchairs or have other mobility impairments.
We've also been talking about how we can work on making the system more accessible going forward. So Jennifer and I were just talking about trying to set up some time for people who get services from AHRC who struggle with public transportation to share their experiences with the MTA, possibly to do ride-alongs with MTA staff, so that they can see firsthand what kinds of struggles that the people we support face every day.
Improving accessibility is one of the 4 top line priorities for the New York City Transit President, Andy Byford's, and his subway action plan. Over the next 5 years, the MTA plans to make 50 more stations accessible.
Why a city like New York doesn't have a reliable transit system in comparison to others part of the world?
Well, I think it depends how you define reliability. At the end of the day, this is a very capable transit system. We move between the buses and the subways, we move 8 million people a day. And most people don't get delayed. Most people, most journeys are completed without any problems. But the real issue is it's a very old system. It suffered from decades of investment. So we now need to take tangible actions to resignal the subway, to make our system accessible, to reimagine the bus network and get the buses running more quickly so that we really can be on a par with the very best in the world.
In what way the MTA has improved the accessibility for the customers?
Well, we've been on a long journey for accessibility. And behind me, you can probably see all the buses lined up. This bus is from 1956. It's a great old machine, but it is completely inaccessible. Whereas you look to our right there, you've got a brand new electric, so a nice environmentally friendly bus, but that is fully accessible. So we've basically been on a journey to make our bus fleets accessible, to progressively equip them firstly with lifts, but then more latterly with ramps. And we now have a fully accessible bus fleet. The big remaining challenge is to make our subway system accessible. Only around 25% of the stations are accessible. So over the next 5 years, we will be making 50 more stations accessible, so that within 5 years, you'll be no more than two stops away from an accessible station. And then over the following 5 years, pushing on to make as many stations accessible as possible.
So in other words, it's 25% right now, but you'll eventually get to 50%, right?
Absolutely. I mean, the aim is over the next 10 to 15 years to make the subway fully accessible.
To implement new projects or make improvements in the transit system, we should expect new fares increases in the near future?
Well, at the end of the day, look, no one wants fare increases, but as with any big organization, costs rise over time. So I don't think it's unreasonable that every couple of years, a fare increase should be one of the measures that we consider as our costs improve, but also as we expand service. But certainly, we've got to get the balance right. The deal, if you like, is we will progressively make service better, putting in elevators, buying new buses, driving up the levels of punctuality and reliability. We may, in the future, need to ask for a fare increase, but we'll balance that against the needs of, say, low-income people. There's now a lower fare that people on low income can enjoy, but also that progressively drive up service and the standard of service so that at least you feel you're getting value for money.
However, Andy Byford's plan seems not to be enough for many people who still claims for accessible service and proper training for drivers.
They are a public servant and they must serve all the public, even the disabled people. The MTA need to give bus drivers sensitivity training in dealing with the disabled.